camp along with Captain Goodwin, and there we saw the men and boys
as thick as hasty pudding. Yankee Doodle, keep it up, Yankee Doodle Dandy. Mind the music and the step, and with the girls be handy.
And there they'd pipe away like fun and play on cornstalk fiddles, and some had ribbons red as blood all bound around their middles. Keep it up, Yankee Doodle Dandy. Mind the music and the step, and with the girls be handy.
And there was Captain Washington upon a slapping stallion, giving orders to his men.
I guess there was a million.
All right, today we're going to continue our historic tour. This Williamsburg area is just rich in history. We are at the Yorktown Battlefield. This one is a national park, so if you have a national park pass, you can get in for free. So what makes Yorktown special and why they honor it is because it is the last major battle of the Revolutionary War with England.
It says that Washington was in the habit of seeking privacy and seclusion where he could commune with himself and where he wrote the most memorable of his dispatches in the Revolutionary War. So, introverts.
Now the French, they had decided to help the American patriots, but not because they supported the American patriot cause during the tyranny of King George III of Great Britain. No, France had a king itself. They didn't want to support a revolution against the king. But France and Great Britain had been fighting each other off and on for nearly 100 years by this point. And the French saw the American Revolutionary War as a wonderful way to possibly weaken some of Great Britain's power and rule. So as soon as France thought that it was advantageous for them to do so, they decided to openly align themselves with the American patriots. And in 1778, France declared war against Great Britain.
Not a lot of things for the kids to do in there. So, you know, it's worth it to go in and see. Probably a good thing to do before you go over to the actual Revolutionary Museum that's just down the road. Just gives you a really good overview of what happened here in Yorktown. There's an auto tour. There's a CD that comes with it. The auto tour is about $5. You buy the CD in the gift shop. So we're gonna take the auto tour, and it drives like 6 or 7 miles around the battlefield, and it's supposed to tell us what happened in this area. So we're gonna head on that now.
Is primarily provided by two expert participants of the siege, Lieutenant Colonel Thomas Dundas of the British Army and Colonel Richard Butler from the American Army.
You have another view of some of our inner defense line. In the no man's land, we tore down all the buildings and cut down all the trees to have a clear view for at least a half mile in front of our lines. Fortunately, a lot of this area was open fields, so we didn't have much work to do.
Tree barricades before the redoubt and surged over the parapet. It was stormed and won.
The taking of the redoubts was a serious blow to our defenses.
So this is what they call the Moore House. This is the house where the surrender details were negotiated. So both sides came here and discussed how the surrender was going to happen. Lastly, after the terms of surrender were agreed upon, this is the field where the British Army was marched out to, and they were forced to lay down all their arms. So they call this field Surrender Field.
Patch, and here's the badges.
Let's see the patch, Hunter.
Well, that. That one looks better.
Yorktown. Actually, let's see the badge.
They look kind of different.
That one. Oh, cool. Very.
So we just got back from the Yorktown National Park and we did the additional auto drive, and you can purchase the CD in the gift shop for $4.95. It's a CD you pop in and listen to as you're going on the drive. It's over an hour long, but we stopped at most of the places, so it took us probably a couple of hours to complete. But I would recommend, if you're gonna drive it and see the grounds there, to get the auto CD. It was actually worth it. It is a well done conversation back and forth between somebody in the British Army and in the US Army, which would be the Colony Army at the time, not the US Army. But it was well done, and it walks you through step by step how the battle took place. And I think the kids enjoyed listening to it rather than just taking a drive and, oh, there's some mounds over there. What do those mean? I don't care. So I think it was definitely worth it for the $5.
Probably some of the information you could have gotten if you would have stopped and just read all of the informational markers. But this format was easier, I think, for a family, because it was done in a voice format. It was more interesting, and all of the ages of our kids would not all have been able to go read it, and I don't think that would have captured their interest as much. So it was a better way, I think, for us to absorb that information. And some of it you could be listening to as you drove, and so by the time you stopped there, then at each stop we let the kids get out and they played for a while, and so I think that it kind of broke it up in a way that they were able to absorb it and, or at least not get tired of it. So I think it was helpful.
Yeah, and our youngest kids are 5 and 7, and so they made it through the whole day. We got there probably 11 o'clock in the morning. We're just getting home now. It's about 5:30, and the only way that they would be able to enjoy a full day like that, because to be honest, there's not a lot in the actual visitor center itself. There's just a small area to look around in. Was because of all the outside stuff. Driving, stopping, hiking around on the barracks or the mounds that they made.
They have a name. What's the name?
Are you testing me?
No, I'm trying to remember. Mm. They were, we needed to know that for the crossword puzzle for their Junior Ranger program.
Okay. It's the trenches that they dug as they attacked Yorktown to drive the British out of it. But there's probably more of an official term for it.
It's going to bother me if I can't.
Oh, well.
I'm going to go look it up.
Okay. Well, it doesn't bother me. It's a trench. So, anyway, lots of places for the kids to run around and see. My wife has found it already. Amazing.
Earthworks.
Oh, wow. What an elaborate name.
No.
Earthworks. Okay. There you go. So that was our day today. Hope you had a great day. See you next time.
English were winning and then the English were losing.
Yeah. What kind of turned the tide of the war? Who started helping the Americans?
French.
The French did, yeah. Otherwise, now you would be British. Wouldn't that be weird?
Yeah.
It's light humor.
There's ha ha. I stole your. I stole quick.
Across the